Do you remember the beauty products that your grandmother used to have? They were homemade, inexpensive, and always smelt amazing. Well, instead of spending your hard-earned cash on magic lotions and potions, you can always go back to basics and create homemade products, just like Nana used to. In her new book, Rebecca Sullivan comes up with a detangler, a cure-all tonic, and other remedies for modern life using ingredients picked from the garden, and she joins us now. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. I love seeing you.
Okay, first of all, what are we making today?
We're actually going to make a man-o-man coffee scrub.
Man-o-man.
Using coffee grinds.
Okay, something
that everyone has left over and doesn't really know what to do with them.
Okay. So I'm actually going to get you started on that.
You're going to get your hands dirty.
Yeah.
So into a bowl, we've got coconut sugar here, if you want to get all of that in there.
The whole thing?
The whole thing.
Oh, wow.
Now, you can use salt or sugar for this recipe, but I find sugar smells a bit nicer on the skin.
It's a pretty colour too.
It's a beautiful colour. You can use normal sugar if you like, raw sugar, white sugar, it doesn't really matter. Not all of that. You're only going to put about a tablespoon of that. Now, that's cocoa butter, so that helps to nourish and moisturise.
Mm-hmm. Is that the same as you use for chocolate crackles?
Similar.
Oh, well, that smells like it.
That is kofa.
Oh, okay.
But it's derived from that.
Okay.
So that's a bit of a more natural form than the old kofa that comes from the cocoa. But how good are they?
Yeah.
And it smells like that. So then you're going to get some of the coffee grinds. So probably about two or three tablespoons of that in there.
So I think you're going to be the mixer, Jess.
Oh, good.
The beautiful thing about this is you're going to want to eat it as well as use it on your skin.
It smells amazing. Mm. More?
Yeah, go for it.
Why not? What would people usually do with coffee grinds
otherwise? Well, there's so many things that you can actually use coffee grinds for. You know when you use the old cafetiere or the plunger at the end of the day? I mean, they're great for the garden.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So it's composting. Composting. Keeps the cats away. The cats, the feral cats, seem to hate it for some reason.
I have three cats. I don't want to keep
those
away.
Well, you don't want to keep those away. Maybe you should skip that step then. Snails hate crawling over them. So if you've got a snail problem, it's also great.
Does it make them crawl faster with the caffeine?
It maybe does.
Okay.
Well, it is actually a booster, so that's why it's so great for this for this scrub, and it's good for cellulite.
Oh, right. Yes.
Okay. So we can put it all over our
bum and legs, and you'll get rid of your cellulite. Hopefully,
now, I think coconut oil is an absolute genius ingredient. How many of these do you put in?
That one. That's perfect.
One. Okay.
Get it in there. And the great thing about this is it's all about experimenting with what you like and what you've got in your cupboard. And then a tablespoon of honey, and then we'll get our mixing on.
Okay.
Another great thing for the coffee grinds, if you put a little dish in the back of your fridge, it'll help absorb odours.
Oh.
And you can also do that in your house, so you can put little dishes around your house and it will get rid of those bad smells.
Of course, because they have that at the sort of the perfume section.
When you're at the counter.
Yeah, that's right.
Definitely.
To clear the nostril palate.
It will also extend the shelf life of your flowers if you put it in a vase.
So can I mix?
Mix away. Get those muscles in there.
So
get that all mixed.
Rebecca, where did this come from? Where did this love of sort of going back to basics come from?
So it actually came when I lost my great-grandmother. I've worked in food for a really long time.
Yeah.
And when she passed away, my mum kept some of her things for me because I was living in London. And in her things were all these certificates. And it turns out she was this award-winning baker for her Victoria sponge. And my little heart broke into a million pieces.
Sponge.
Victoria sponge. Everyone loves a good sponge.
Yeah.
But because she passed away and I hadn't seen her cook, I was heartbroken. Working in food and not seeing your great-grandmother create this recipe that she'd won awards for.
Mm.
So I've been on this mission ever since to protect our granny skills. So you've got your granny skills on right now. And granny skills are all of those things that we you know, sort of take for granted, like the pickling and the preserving.
Mm.
And now I've taken that one step further by creating a book that extends into the whole home.
And beauty products especially. I mean, run us through a couple of things you have over here. You have a homemade blush.
Homemade blush. Which I think is phenomenal.
Look at this, Jess.
It's my favourite thing in the world. It takes about 30 seconds to make. It's cocoa powder, so raw cocoa powder.
So chocolatey.
Chocolate. So your cheeks are going to smell yummy as well. Arrowroot. Which is the starch.
From the biscuits.
From the biscuits. So the arrowroot flour, and that's all you need. And then a little bit of colouring, which you can use beetroot powder. Or rose powder. And I've used something called mica powder, which you can get online. It's very inexpensive.
Yes.
That's the other beautiful thing about this. You're going to save yourself probably about $25
making it this way.
Yeah.
And then can you pop some on me?
Dab a little bit on there.
Just a little bit.
And you can use that as dry shampoo as well, which is great. You just take the colour out, so you make it
the same way. Because I love a blush.
I'm a bit of a blush queen as well. I love a bit of blush.
Am I putting it on right?
Yeah, that looks beautiful, Sarah.
And you've got blush costs about $1.20 versus $30.
I haven't
love it.
Blended that in properly, but that's great.
I like
the colour's fantastic.
Now, look, you've made a perfect scrub there.
I think it's time we try this.
Really
and we have a man who likes his coffee.
A man-o-man.
A man-o-man.
Oh, man.
Oh, man. Hello. Have a seat. Just, how do you find your skin, Damien?
Oh, it's pretty good. I moisturise. I moisturise. I scrub in the shower, yeah. I mean, I scrub my face in the shower.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, that's very metrosexual of you. Yeah. Isn't it?
A tiny bit more.
Just a little bit off the side.
Well, we're actually using your coffee.
I know. Yes. It was warm, too. I'm excited.
It smells incredible.
So let's whack right. it on in. Any dry areas that we need to get to?
Just the forehead. I've got Mediterranean heritage.
Yeah. And maybe around the nose. Often the nose is quite...
Can you show us how to do it, Rebecca?
Perfect. Yeah. I'm going to actually spritz a little bit of this honey and rose toner on your face first. Because your face isn't wet, normally you'd be in the shower, obviously, so you'd have a wet face already. Okay. So if you want to close your eyes for me...
And you made this too?
I did. This is just warm water, some natural local honey, some raw honey, a little bit of rose oil. And if you've got dry skin, you would use a little bit of coconut oil in there. And if you've got...
How fabulous.
Dry skin, coconut oil, and oily skin, a little bit of apple cider vinegar.
Okay.
So,
let's get scrubbing.
Yeah. Let's get scrubbing on this
Where's
face.
Where's Joan?
Of
that song.
Close those eyes.
Oh my goodness.
Oh. We're making a bit of a mess. Ooh. But if you're in the shower, beautiful. It doesn't matter because it would just go down the drain. So,
And that's okay to go down the drain?
Absolutely, because it's just sugar. So it's going to dissolve. Look at you. Look at that.
You're a good sport.
I thought this was supposed to be a treat.
It will when you lick up the leftovers. Okay. That'll be the treat.
Something I lick my face?
And your skin looks better already. It's glowing.
Shiny.
It's glowing underneath.
Dama, how does it feel? Does it feel scratchy?
Yeah, it does feel a bit scratchy. Does it a bit scratchy? I like being pampered, though.
Here we go. Let's get in this side.
Yeah, get some pampering on.
Get in there.
And so the sugar acts as the exfoliant, which is going to get rid of any dry skin or anything
like
that.
Not really. Sorry.
He didn't make my coffee nice.
Gentle.
Feel this, Jess?
Perfect.
Oh, you're glowing.
You are glowing, Damien. Well done. Now, Rebecca's book, The Art of the Natural Home, a room-by-room guide, it is out now. It is a gorgeous book, Rebecca Sullivan. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me, ladies. Thank you.
Thank you.
Fantastic.